Rambo, everybody. It's Saturday morning. It's 11 a.m. It's time for the forfeit. I'm on location at Edgerton Primary School today. We're going to be playing. We are the champions. Here's your teams. So there are teams. This is how the competition is going to work. We've got four games. The loser of each game will have to do a forfeit. The first game is going to be toilet roll kick-ups. Here we go. First up is Team Edgerton. We've got Mrs. Bagnall, which will be followed by Mrs. Hooper. They only get one go at this. Let's see what their score is. Two. Next up is Team Winsham. We've got Mrs. Mushin, followed by Mr. Babington. Three is leading so far. Next up, we've got Team Multiflex, Mr. Murray, followed by Mr. Ray.
Oh, rubbish.
So Multiflex are winning with 8 kick-ups, but the other two teams are tying. So we're going to nominate one person from each team to have one more go in a sudden death kick out. Two. Mr. Babington suddenly turned into Lionel Messi. That meant that Multiflex won the first game, but Edgerton lost the first game. That means Edgerton are going to have to do the forfeit. The forfeit today is to be mummified. They're going to be wrapped up in toilet roll, and then they're going to have to walk around the playground like a mummy. Over to you guys. So, Multiflex won the first game, now on to the second game. This is the long stand. What they've got to do is take their trainer off, hold it above their head with two hands, and stand on one foot. The longest person to do that will win it for their team. It doesn't have to be both, just one person, the last one in, will win. When both players are out, that means that team lose and they do the forfeit. As Edgerton lost the first one, they don't have to start till 10 seconds after everyone else. Okay guys, shoes off, okay. Above your heads. Leg, you only need
one of your team to stay in to win. Off you go. One,
edge
to
the start.
On
one leg.
Oh no, this is what it's
going to be. Keep your balance, guys. Keep your balance.
I don't know about my phone in my pocket.
What I never could have hoped to win. You're stopping down the road and leaving me again. The threats you made were meant to cut me down. And if my love was just a circus, you'd be a clown by now. And no, I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true soul.
going to call it a tie.
The team from Multiflex have very kindly let the team from Winsham distribute this forfeit. As Edgerton lost again, Mrs. Hooper and Mrs. Bagnall will be doing an ice bucket. Mr. Babington has requested Mrs. Hooper just for you, Ben.
Just for you, Ben.
Okay, Mr. Babington, you're up first.
Enjoy, Ben.
Next up, Mrs. Mushin, ice buckets, Mrs. Bagnall. So on to game three. Game three, I'm trying to be nice because they've been doing so well, the teams, I thought I'd give them a treat. So I'm going to take them bowling and then I'm going to give them a hot dog. Okay, so the bowling game is the same as Mrs. Hooper's game. We've got tights on our head, a tennis ball in the end. You've got to swing your head and knock over all the Skittles. It's a time challenge. Fastest time wins. Slowest time does the forfeit. Here goes. Take your marks. Go. Just you, Mr. Ray.
Oh!
Yeah! Wow. So Multiflex did it in 35 seconds. Next up is Team Edgerton. And as they lost the last game, they get a slight advantage. You can take one bottle out each, girls. Which one would you like, Mrs. Hooper?
Oh, each.
Yeah. Okay. On the stopwatch.
Three.
Team Edgerton scored a huge 1 minute. Now it's down to Team Winsham, okay? Let's see if they can beat it. If they do it in less than a minute, then Team Edgerton are going to have to do the forfeit again. Don't you think this is the most glamorous Mrs. Mushin has ever looked? Okay. Three, two, one, go. What was the time?
It was 1 minute 12 seconds.
Yeah! So as Winsham lost that game, Edgerton want to get them back on the forfeit and they're going to be having a hot dog. So the hot dog's going to go in their mouth, the bun on the sides, and then they can have as much tomato ketchup as they like. Here's the forfeit. So we're on to our final game now. We're going to be playing Hungry Hungry Hippos. This is something you've never seen before from your teachers. Okay, if you just look across at Mrs. Hooper here, she's lying flat on a skateboard, ready to be pushed with her crate to collect the balls, which are in the middle here. Okay, we've got Mrs. Mushin and Mr. Babington over there, and the team from Multiflex just to the left. So the rules of the game are this: once they push them in, they've got to put the crate down. They can only put the crate down once. Withdraw back to their other crate, swap the person, put the balls in the other crate. The team with the most balls wins. Because Multiflex haven't lost one yet, we're going to give them a little bit of a hindrance. Edgerton and Winsham are going to come into the middle, collect their first crate, and Multiflex will start after that. That's the game. Here it goes. 3, 2, 1, go! Hungry Hippos. Team Edgerton scored 36. Woo! Team Winsham scored 34. Woo! And Team Multiflex scored 32. Yay! So this is our final forfeit, and as we did Hungry Hungry Hippos, we've got two buckets of hippo snot, and they're going to be going on a Multiflex coach's heads. Look how excited Mrs. Hooper and Mrs. Bagel are.
Can't wait.
Here's your final forfeit. There we go, Mrs. Hooper.
Oh yes. Are you ready? Are you steady?
No. Oh.
It's warm but not room.
Oh, snap.
It's all looking up. This
is on. So that is the end of the We Are The Champions competition. I hope you enjoyed it. A big thank you goes to all the teachers that took part. Big round of applause. Yay! All that's left to do now is announce the winner. And the winner, winning 3 out of 4 games, is Team Multiflex.
We are the champions. No time for losers, cause we are the champions of the world.
That's the end of your forfeit. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. Remember, everybody,
be kind, be safe,
watch this space.